so nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
I'm Kristen Schaffkamp.
Yes,
nice to meet you.
This is my daughter, Jade.
Hi, Jade. Nice to meet you.
And this is Professor
Clovis.
My
gosh, you're adorable. Oh, he is something.
Look at him. He's just not cute at all,
oh,
right?
Oh, he's awful. Just absolutely awful. How often was he vomiting?
A couple times a day.
Oh, well, that's a lot. So I know you've been through this kind of stuff before, and a liver shunt is most likely what we're worried about. We can ultrasound him today. There are surgical options only if it's a single shunt in an area that we can access.
Right.
So if he has multiple shunts, that would be bad news because that means it's not a surgical
right.
type of problem.
And what would the prognosis be on that for him, do you think?
I would say most of those dogs that present with multiple shunts at this young of an age, we're probably not gonna get past 1 year of age. Okay, well, I'm gonna take Mr. Schmoopit.
Nobody run away with him.
I cannot guarantee that at all.
I'm super nervous.
I do see what I believe to be a single shunt right in this area. Looking at the blood vessels, I don't see evidence of multiple shunts, which is good news because that's not surgically correctable.
That's good news.
Yeah,
that's great news. So, just a rough estimate, do you think?
I would estimate close to 5,000, but I will talk to the surgeon and get you a better estimate.
Worth every penny if we can save his life and give him a good quality of life, even if it's 6 to 8 years. I have a feeling this little guy is going to prove those statistics wrong.
Yeah.
He'll be like 12 years old and be like, I got this.
I sure hope so. That would be amazing.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome, ladies.
Do you want me to carry him?
No.
The news about Professor Clovis is great, but the cost is going to be an issue. The surgery plus pre- and post-operative cost is going to be close to $7,000. So I need to get approval from the Panda Paws Rescue Board. Panda Paws Rescue is a nonprofit organization that operates off of donations. So we have a board in place that can help manage and monitor those funds so we use them appropriately. My board of directors is myself, Patty, Jeff, Lisa, and my best friend, Sadie. So does anyone want to speak up and tell me what your thoughts are?
Well, I want actually. I'm quite comfortable with it. It sounds just exactly like what we discussed.
Okay. Patty votes yes. Sadie?
An 80% chance that he'll pull through, right?
80% chance that he would do well and have a lifespan of 6 to 8 years.
I think that's great, so I vote yes.
Jeff, what are your thoughts?
Yeah, I don't see a problem with that. I mean, it sounds well within reason to spend that type of money to give an animal, you know, 6 to 8 years. That's what we're all about.
Yeah.
Are you ready for your big day today?
When I have to make the decision of whether a dog is going to go through surgery or not, I basically am looking at the prognosis without surgery versus the prognosis with surgery. And what are the statistical odds of that animal surviving the surgery?
Be good babies. It's crispy cold, huh? All right, little dude.
This surgery, it's risky. It's definitely very risky. But with the surgery, we potentially can buy him 6 to 8 years, if not longer. And those are healthy years, so it's worth it for him. Without this surgery, he will only live about 1 to 2 years, and it would be rough. His blood will have so much toxicity in it that essentially it will poison him to death. It will kill him.
It's a serious surgery, but not as serious as those eyebrows. All right, bud, we're here. Do you want to get out? I got you. Yeah, I got you. And we'll bring your button, too. I know you love him.
Well, sweetie pie.
Look, you're like a superstar. This is your dressing room.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
I'm well, thank you.
This is Professor Clovis.
Hi. You can't make it any cuter than a Schnauzer puppy. We see the shunt. We see where it is. This is not a normal vessel. The portal vein should be right over here and start blossoming into the liver.
Like, psh.
Exactly. And instead, it's going straight down there.
Mm-hmm.
So I am worried, Amanda. We have the kind of shunt that I did not expect. He has an abnormality at the end of the liver, which is almost more of an intrahepatic shunt.
Mm-hmm.
This should not be continuous. So our problem is somewhere here. We have to decide, because it's a higher risk, is whether we're going in or not. as good as a CT is, sometimes we're surprised by what we find in there. Mm-hmm. And so, but at least this will tell me where to look, mm-hmm. which is a huge help. There's a good chance that we can put a ring on it, as we were talking about, put that device on.
But we won't know till you get in there and see it.
Exactly. Let's prep and go into the OR. Yeah.
For me, I'm nervous for Professor Clovis. I'm nervous for the doctor. This is a big, big deal. This is not at all what we were expecting. This isn't actually the greatest of news either, so it's gonna be a much more challenging surgery, if surgery is even possible. So right now we just need to get in there, get our eyes on it, and this has gone from an urgent to an emergent situation. So we'll see what we see when we get in there.
And we are scrubbed and ready.
First cut.
So the vessel is here. It's a very tricky spot, and I have to remove some liver tissue to access the vessel.
What are you seeing so far?
I may have to open the diaphragm.
Every single time there's anesthesia, it makes me the most nervous. It could kill him in surgery. It's very stressful. Can you see the shunt yet, or?
Yes, so what I'm doing right now, I'm working on trying to dissect it enough that I can place a ring around it. It's an intrahepatic. It's just that it's exiting far enough outside the liver that I have a chance of doing it. Right now I have isolated the vessel.
This is a metal ring. The vessel will go in through here, and this material right here will absorb bodily water fluids, and it will absorb slowly over about a month's time, and that green ring you see will start to basically close like this because it's absorbing. Very slowly is the key, and then eventually it will completely constrict that shunt. That's the goal. Once the shunt is constricted, the blood will be able to flow through the liver normally.
This one's going to be insanely hard to place just because of the size and location of the vessel. If we tear the vessel, we're done. Mm-hmm. So we'll see.
This is very nerve-wracking. This is stressful. There's a ton of anxiety. He's in an all-out war right now with that shunt to try to see if he can get that ring around it.
We're making good progress, but just not getting it fully around.
Is it on it? It is?
Yes, it is.
We have one.
So that's one good thing. So now.
And then we can celebrate.
Okay, well, that's my baby
and
celebration.
And then we're gonna watch what happens. So with an intrahepatic shunt, the prognosis is not 90%.
Okay.
It's somewhere between 50 and 70%. Really, it's gonna be over the next 24, 48 hours that we'll know. And he is going to worry me a bit.
Right now, the doctor is closing up his abdomen.
Good boy, Snoopy.
He will be in the ICU monitored all night long here. He is very extremely critical. Oh my goodness.
Hi, Smoopy. How are you feeling, huh? Look at you in your fancy party hat.
So the total for Professor Clovis today is going to be $5,423.65.
Chunk change. Take my card. You're worth it, buddy. Every penny.
Adorable. And I think by the time we're done with all of his care, he's probably going to be close to $8,000. There goes Professor Clovis's college tuition. He's now just going to have to rely on his street smarts. It is a huge gamble to put $7,000 or $8,000 into one animal, but when this is a puppy that has the potential of living a full lifespan, that's worth it to me. That money is going to give a family a companion for years to come. Thank you, ladies. That's priceless.